Okay. My my other phone, I had to go get another phone. Okay, so we're back to trying to blow out the ice maker where the inlet, water inlet is. I can't see it. Well, let's try it the other way. I want to put this right in the here. They said there might be ice in this up in here, and that would cause it to, you want to make sure and get that out of there, it cause it to dribble like it's been doing and leaking, you know, leaking. But I did see a lot of I saw a lot of kind of like steam, whatever it is you get when something's really cold. Let's do that again. I wanted to blow backwards in case there was something stuck in there, but really I don't think there's probably not anything in the hose. It would be in that filter or that screen. It's not a real filter. I don't think I can get this together. And I want to I got my camera in my way here. Let's see. I wanted to feel the airflow. Get it inside there, and I don't want to stretch it out anyway. Need four hands. Ah, I think I see where the, there it is. Okay. I don't think my air blower will go up in there though. Okay, yeah. I felt air coming through. So I don't think that it's... I was like, what's that noise? It's my brand new air compressor. I just set it up today. It's really loud. But that was 125 pounds of pressure, so that should do the job. It'll do 150. Now I've got to do a bunch of crazy stuff with this. I think what was happening before is the power... Well, anyway, the phone kept rebooting, and then it didn't want to boot back up. So we're going to try to keep it running. I forgot about the ice. I'm going to put the ice pick in there. Luckily, I have several of these phones. Well, let's get... we'll be there in a minute. Now, I may have to, that's as low as I can get this one. That's why I was using the other one, but I may have to film it, the reinstallation from there. I think I'm going to have to set where that is, though. So, let's see. Maybe I'll put it over here. It's even worse. Yes. Sorry. That That's what happened. Yeah, that's what I thought. Close as I'm going to be able to get. Okay, but at least now I can work. Okay, I'm not going to unplug it because I can unplug it for a minute. It's still running, and of course I've made it run even more. Let's unplug it. I'm not worried so much about getting shocked. I'm worried about getting the ice maker out of whack. Okay, it goes on here like this. Do that. Tell the difference. Got a mark on that side. I wonder if I did that last time. Now there's some junk that was in that old one. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and stick this. Shouldn't hold it. And then I'm really close to cutting myself on that. Okay, now let's plug it back in. I can screw it all up all together as it plugs in. Cords, I had them out of the way and now they're in the room. Okay. They're all, the screws are all the same. So that ain't gonna matter. If I do this, I won't be knocking the cords around. They're all the same length. Okay, so let's get this in. If that needs to be more that way or more that way. I'm going to go more that way because the cover might be more likely to fit. I can always adjust it in a minute. Now, cover needs to go back on me first, and then the this out, I did all the vacuuming and everything, so that part doesn't need to be done again. Now the fan's still running, but the compressor's not running. And I didn't quite figure out the best way to route that last time. I think it should be like that. Yeah. I tried something different last time. Yeah, so I saw a bunch of green slime. I'll try to show it in a minute. So that it was probably clogged up to where it wouldn't work right anymore. But I'm gonna figure. Now, hopefully that means we're gonna be good when we put it all back together. Let's get
it just started and then. Try to line that. Strain relief on the power cord, and there, strain relief for the water line is right there. Okay. I don't want to tie them all up in case it has to be jiggled around to get them all out. Let's see. Cover, it doesn't need to be real tight, it's just tough cardboard. It's not even masonite. Water line, put that on there. And I messed it up. So let's try and aim it back over there. Well, we're working. Okay, yeah. Here's our water line. There's a couple more paper towels I can use. And our old one. Okay, while I'm thinking about it, I don't know if I can show that good or not. Well, that is some, all that greenish stuff, if it looks green in the picture, it may look black. That's all what just happened and accidentally fall out of there while I was taking that apart. So I think it was clogged up. The valve was probably not actually bad. And it fell back out of here, evidently. I could have felt, no. I can see that stuff in there now after I moved it around enough. So yeah, you know what, I'll try blowing that out from the other backwards here in a minute. See what happens. I wouldn't put it back on the refrigerator, but if you just want to make a project with an AC controlled water valve, then there you go. That's what I kind of thought already. Let's see. Let's get the water line on there. Now this, see, is a compression fitting. I don't know if you can see it, but so the Teflon tape would really, if anything, just get in the way. It wouldn't help. So I'm not doing that. Oops. That's about where I needed it. So, yeah, I had to move it so that the hose would reach. I just remembered that. Get my AC cord away from where there might be water leaking. Okay, so there's a little rubbery protective. Keep the dirt out. Keep the threads from getting messed up. I think I should reroute that cord when I plug it in and have it go. Actually, no, it's going that way. Still, I think it shouldn't be behind that water deal. So I'll reroute it. I think that way if it ever gets yanked, it won't yank the water deal. Dry it up, turn the water on, and see if it's going to be all right. Okay. Let's make sure that that's... Yeah, that's getting tight. That's one thing I hate about these. They fall out fast as you can... Faster than you can use them. Good old Craftsman quality. You know, they used to make good stuff. How about that set in 2000? And let's see. Can I get, what do I do here? Turn on the water. Turned on the water, and I turned on the ice one. No leak. We're good. That's a pretty good hose and connector there. Now, I don't like the the plastic one. You got to. It's okay too. Those are the ones that I've had used to have trouble with when they. I hated those kind of things when they first came out with them. They were always. Leak like, you know, you couldn't hardly get them to seal. But it's better now. Now we'll have to wait and see if it makes ice. That's how we'll know if it's fixed. Okay. Have to put you back. And I'm going to have to put some of these tools up. Pick them up. So that I can don't flip over on my head when I'm moving this stuff around. Okay, yeah. Put this over this way and we'll see if we can raise it up. First we gotta get it unhooked from the kit. Good. Sorry. Again. Okay. There's a top of the refrigerator. There we go. Okay, so it's got to go back over there. So first I'm going to unplug it because I won't be able to record it. I'm gonna have to unplug the camera. I hope it doesn't kill the video. So far, so good. There we go. I think we're still good. All right. So this back in. This. Power strip was off, so I've been running on battery this whole time anyway. we shut the door. Now let's see if we can. I don't know if we can reach over there to look in with it plugged in or not. I can only leave it unplugged for about the max you ever get is 10 minutes on the battery with this camera out. Let's my tripod. Running like it should. Of course, it'll be a long time before it makes ice. Won't know if it's going to leak or anything until can't see that. Anyway, if you didn't know, you know, you flip the, on them, almost all of them, you can see it right there. Flip it up to turn it off, flip it down to turn it on. Let's shut it and let it run. Seems all right. So, now that I've got a big mess of, this was 10 times harder. Now I've accidentally unplugged everything again. It's 10 times harder making a video when the cameras quit, when the phones start shutting themselves down or rebooting or whatever the heck they were doing. I think it's shutting itself down and I had to turn it back on. And then it wouldn't, and then it wouldn't come back on that other one. Now, I think what was happening, it usually happens when I'm moving them and they're plugged in. It causes the power to connect, disconnect and reconnect. And it, on some of the, well, that phone is really bad, causes it to shut down and reboot. And this one, I did it three or four times and it didn't hurt it one bit just now. So, never know. Okay, I'll get my green stuff over there. Oh yeah, I wanted to go try blowing out that. Yeah, let's do that. Do it outside, I won't do that in here. Since my air is right here, you get it? Oh really? Is it still leaking? Maybe it'll adjust itself after a while. Well, I got the new valve in there and I turned the ice maker back on and all that stuff. If it starts making ice and don't leak, we'll be good. The old one was, I don't think it was bad. I think it was really just clogged up real bad. But they say if you try to take them apart, they usually don't, they leak when you put them back together. So. Hopefully. Okay, sorry, had to talk. So, all right, now, how am I going to do this? I'm going to turn it around this way so that I'm going to be able to see what I'm doing. There we go. Maybe, is that going to be a good enough background for that? Maybe. Let's try it. I think the outdoors might make it to where you can't see it. So here is the inlet where I cut it off. And I think that white's making it camera shut down the lighting. Let's try pointing in a dark part of the area here. Somewhere. There's white everywhere I go. That's even more bright. Ah, the door. I don't, hopefully nobody will come through the door. Okay. Now, this is where I cut off the plastic tubing And that is the outlet. So, and this is the inlet that's clogged. And there's a screen right in here somewhere, here or there. So you really have to take it apart to get to it. And that's why I didn't even try it, because I saw that in the videos. Someone took apart, and I thought, yeah, I think they're right. So I'm going to try blowing through here. Well, I don't know if you can see it, but it blew up about 4 feet. So it's clean now. It doesn't seem super easy to blow through it. Now it's not open now, so can't blow through it now, but it's not open. You have to put power to it to get it to open. So really I'm forcing it backwards, you know, the backwards through the valve, and that's the only reason I'm able to do it. I guess that's why it's resistant so much. I'm forcing the valve open. All that's sharp and it hurts. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, it was 125 pounds of pressure is what I got that thing set on. So I have a feeling that it would probably work again, but I mean, like I said, I might, if I had, usually when you do, if you did do a project, you probably wouldn't want to have to do 110 volts. You'd want, you know, DC 12 volts or something, or 5 volts. But anyway, it's pretty cool, and I'm gonna keep it because I don't think there's actually anything, you know, wrong with it. I think it was just clogged up. And that is an Invesis. It's an Invesis, and the one I bought is the same thing. Invesis 2315576, made in Mexico, and it's a Whirlpool fridge and freezer, and I do not remember the model number, and so I can't look it up right now because. But actually, I found out these are the typical ones put on most Whirlpool ice makers. So look your model number up of your refrigerator, freezer, whatever you got, and if you're, you know, you're getting ice bergs inside of your freezer, around all in your ice bucket and in the back of your freezer. Like we were for a long time because we hadn't fixed it. That could be the cause. Look up, you see other videos in more detail, the ones that, like, by the people that sell the parts and stuff. But I ended up, instead of buying it from one of those parts supply places, it was $40, $45 on there. So, and I have bought parts from them, and usually, like, for the washer and dryer, they're pretty reasonable. But for some reason, this exact same brand and everything was on Amazon for $16. So I got it. That other one that I put on. All right, so I'm gonna go. Bye bye.